Miss Clara, I've done something bad. I'm going through chemo. I have a lot of pain, nausea. I called a friend of mine, James, to get me some pot, to help me get through the chemo. And now I find out he's been arrested. It's all my fault. I'm responsible.
Yesterday,
I don't know what to do.
All my troubles seem so far.
I don't know what to do.
Dee, do you realize what you've done? You caused him a lot of trouble. You shouldn't have done that, Dee. You shouldn't have asked him to do that.
He's in trouble. And I believe you've helped me so much that you'll be able to help him by talking to him. What am I going to do? I would like to call James. And I would like you to speak to him for me. He needs help. I'm responsible.
Dee, I know, I realize James might need help, but I don't know him. I really never seen him. But
he's in trouble, and I believe you've helped me so much that you'll be able to help him by talking to him.
I don't mind helping him, Dee, but, well, I don't mind helping anyone, but by me not knowing him, you know.
He's a good boy. He's a good boy, and he made a mistake. I made a mistake.
I realize that we all make mistakes, but I tell you what I can do. I could ask him to come here like Wednesday at 4 o'clock after school. I can meet with him and talk to him and try to help.
I will call him and I'll let him know that he can come see you.
So, I mean, you're supposed to be some kind of spiritual guider, and you know, I mean, some kind of guidance with this Bible. I've been referred to you by Miss D, and I mean, look at the situation I'm in. Miss Clara, how can your God help me? You tell me that.
James, Miss D called me and asked me to talk to you, to try to help you and give you advice. This is all I know to do. God is the only one that I know that can help you. If he helped me, he can help you. So I'm giving you advice. I was asked to help you. So this is what I know to do anyway, to just try to help you. So I can only give you the only thing that I know. But if you feel in the way you feel, then, you know, you come to me, James.
I don't understand. What can your God do, though? I mean, really, when it comes down to it, what, it's heaven or it's hell? And what's in between? You know, what's for the guy for me? Look, I try to help somebody, and this is the situation I'm in.
Listen, James, listen. You come to me, and you ask me for advice. I'm giving you the advice that all I know is you ask God to help you, and I know that he will. You give everything else a try. Give God a try.
I really don't think God can help me. I don't believe that God can help me, Miss Claire. He hasn't done anything for me. Look at this situation I'm in now. Am I supposed to learn something from this? This is just trouble for me.
James, you of age, you know right from wrong. You ask me, how can I help you? And I'm giving you advice, the only advice I know. You have to let God help you. That's the only advice I know.
It's God of yours. I hope he forgives, because I got so many sins, it's not even worth talking about.
James, listen to this. This is not my word, but this is God's word. God's word is true. Nothing about it. Nothing about it is untrue. God in his word says, "For if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if ye forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. So whatever that you do, whatever that you have done, God will forgive you. Now, man may never forgive you, but God will. You either have a choice. You either want to listen to my advice of me telling you what God can help you and how he can help you, or you're not going to be able to be helped.
See, man don't care about me. Cops, Miss D, everybody lets me down. You're just going to be another person who lets me down. Just like this God you speak of. What's he going to do for me? I don't understand. How's he better than any man?
There's none greater than him. Have you tried him? Answer me. Have you tried what I'm asking you to do?
I grew up in church, but that stuff ain't for me. I mean,
basically, have you tried, James? Have you tried? I'm giving you the advice, the only advice I know. Have you tried? Now, it seems everything else you tried has failed. Have you tried what I'm asking you to try? Have you tried, God? Have you tried him?
I'll never be able to accept God the way you do. He doesn't care for me. Look at me. I'm nothing.
James, God is no respecter person. What he has done for me, he'll do for you. But basically, I'm asking you, have you tried him? Now, look at the situation you're in. You're saying no one else cares for you. I'm telling you someone that cares for all of us. His word said, cast all my cares, your cares, on him, for he cares for you.
I'll tell you what, here's some care. I don't care. I don't want to hear nothing God has to say, or you.
Well, I tell you what, I'll pray for you. That's all that I know the best to do.
I don't need your prayers.
Okay.
Do, but I lost a friend. This friend who should be mad and pissed and angry and want to hurt me physically, mentally, any way he can, he walked up and he shook my hand. I mean, why did he shake my hand? If I was him, I would want me dead. I would want me dead now in any way I can. Was this some cool twisted joke of life from God?
Well, first of all, we must have a forgiving heart. You was doing your job. You didn't do anything wrong. Do you realize you might have saved his life? Have you thought on those terms? Although that was your friend, and you might feel like you did him more harm than good, but at the same time, you had to do your job. You did what you had to do. You got him to see that what he done was wrong. So don't be angry with yourself. When he shook your hand, it wasn't a joke. He understood that at the same time, he knew that you was his friend.